Hey everybody, I've decided to make a series of tutorial videos for Final Cut Pro 10. Now, this is designed for beginners who decided to step up from using iMovie or other similar free program to someone with a little more power under the hood. In this first lesson, I'm going to go over how to properly import files into Final Cut Pro. If you enjoy this video, please hit the like button below and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the rest of my videos. First, I'd like to go over the structure of Final Cut Pro 10 and how it organizes your files. Your videos you record on your camera, or the songs you download and want to use for your video, are classified as clips. Clips that have at least one or two things in common are then grouped into events. For example, if you go away skiing for a weekend, you can have all your footage from day one in one event and day two in a different one. Or all your GoPro footage in one and all your DSLR footage in a different event. This will save time in finding your footage if you have lots of clips. All your events are then grouped into a library container. Personally, I like to have a different library for every video I make. This way, I only see clips that I need for my video when I'm editing. It also makes it easier to archive my videos when I'm done. So let's get started. I have some motorcycle footage I'd like to edit into a video. I'll open Final Cut Pro 10 and create a new library. Click File, New, Library. I'll name it Bike Trip. Now here in the library pane, you have two default events. Smart Collections, which we'll talk about later, and an event with today's date. You can rename this event right now if you'd like, or you can leave it. I'm going to rename it and call it Day 1. To import footage, I can go to File, then Import, or use a keyboard shortcut Command-I, or click this Import button. An Import Media window will open up. Now you navigate to your media you'd like to import, whether it's on a memory card, external hard drive, or on your desktop. I have the videos on my desktop, so I'll navigate and click on the first one I want to import. The video pops up in the viewer where you can review it. Notice how playback is choppy and some frames are dropped? That's because it's a compressed file, and your computer has to decompress it and play it at the same time. Unless you have a powerful computer, it'll struggle with that. But that can be fixed. Let's select one clip for now and go through the import options. At the top here, you can select to add it to an existing event or create a new event in your library. This clip is from day 2, so I'm going to select Create New Event, choose which library I put it in, and name it Day 2. Under that, you have the option to copy clip to library or leave it in place. If you select Copy to Library, Final Cut Pro will create a duplicate of your video. If you choose to leave files in place, then Final Cut Pro will just create a shortcut to wherever you have the file stored. If your videos are on a memory card or an external hard drive that can be unplugged, it's best to select Copy to Library option. That way, if you remove your memory card or unplug your hard drive, your files don't go missing. On the other hand, if your videos are already on your built-in hard drive, you can choose to leave files in place to save storage space. Next, you can choose to create optimized media and or create proxy media. Remember the choppy playback and drop frames before? This is where you fix that. If you select Create Optimized Media, Final Cut Pro decompresses and converts your video file to Apple's own format, which is optimized for editing. The pros of this are, 1, you get to keep the same resolution and frame rate, and 2, you'll be able to play and edit these files on an older computer, which might struggle with compressed files. The downsides to optimized media is it will take a considerable amount of time to render the files, and they will take up a lot of space on your hard drive. Optimized files can be up to 10 times larger than the original compressed file. Your other option is to create proxy media. Proxy media is also Apple's format, which is optimized for editing. But instead of creating a large file, Final Cut Pro creates a small file with lower resolution and only plays back every second frame. These proxy files are more than sufficient for most editing. And once your edit is complete, you can switch back to original media with full resolution and full frame rate for color grading and final export. The file sizes are considerably smaller than the original media, so they won't eat up much hard drive space. But, just like creating optimized media, these files can take time to render. Next, if you have all your media organized in folders and apply tags to them, you can select these options to create smart collections after import. Also, if you select Find People, Final Cut Pro will scan your videos for faces and add them to smart collections. Under that, we have the option to analyze videos for balance color. If you select this box, Final Cut Pro will analyze your video to see if the color needs to be corrected. It won't actually correct the clip, it will just analyze it. Later on, you will be able to automatically correct color if it's analyzed. So, if you have time to let it render, select this box. That way, later on when color grading, you will not have to wait. But if you want to start editing right away, leave this box unchecked. You can easily analyze clips that need to be corrected at any time. You can also analyze and correct audio, but I usually leave these unchecked and fix it when doing my audio pass, which I will discuss later on. Next, I'm going to command click all the videos I want to import into my day one event, select all my settings, and click import selected button. The import media window closes, and all my clips are in the event browser. The progress bar shows my videos are rendering. For more details, you can click on and a progress window will pop up. I'll close that for now. While waiting, I'll go back to my import window and import clips into my day two event. Once my files are done rendering, you can see my playback is still choppy. That's because I'm still viewing my original compressed media. In the top corner of the viewer display, select View and check Proxy Media. Now you are viewing proxy files Final Cut Pro created earlier. If I play one, notice how the playback is nice and smooth. You can also import audio files and pictures the same way. From here, you can start creating your video, but I like to first organize all my clips, pick usable parts, and get rid of all the footage I don't use. I'll show you guys how to do that in my next video. Hit the subscribe button below so you don't miss it. I'll link it up top and in the description once posted. Thanks for watching, and I hope you come back to watch the rest of my videos.